So we asked the sellers, like, why is the price up now? Oh, because you're a foreigner, you're rich, right? So that's the, he was very honest.
So it does take some perseverance, and it does take some paying of your taxes, so to speak. And so you figured out that knowledge has a value, right? Like that knowledge helps you go from point A to point B. So let's share some of that knowledge with our group. What did you learn along the way?
Right. So along the way, just when it comes to sourcing, along the way, there were a million lessons, right? Even if you work with an agent, you really have to find a reliable one. So when I had my sourcing agency and I just started out and I got some clients in the door and some people that we helped actually source, I needed another agent. So I just went on Upwork and on Fiverr and I was like, I just need an agent. Like, an agent is an agent, right? So I got another agent and it just didn't work out that way. It was just this, it was the same way as it's been before with the factories. Like, it was the same problems that you have, the same issues that you're facing, the same people not coming back to you. And also because, like, it's a different culture. You don't understand the culture. I didn't understand the culture. Even being in China, I'm here 7 years. I speak Chinese. I still don't get the culture sometimes. You know what I mean?
It can be difficult. It seems like the culture is very penny pinching. Like, if they can save a penny on your manufacture run, even if it's got a high risk, they'll do it in a heartbeat.
Yeah, I think it depends though. Like, I think when the mentality is more, for example, there's a coffee shop I like to go to. Sometimes I take my laptop and I want to go do some work, right? So I go down and I'm like, hey, do you guys got Wi-Fi? You have Wi-Fi, right? Yeah, we have Wi-Fi. So I sit down, I order some food, order a coffee. The food is coming. So what's the Wi-Fi password? Oh, the Wi-Fi doesn't work today. I said, what do you mean? I just ask you, do you have Wi-Fi? Yeah, we have Wi-Fi. Does it work? No. You know, so that's the mentality. I didn't. Yeah, it was my mistake though. I just didn't ask the right questions. So instead of me asking, hey, can I use your Wi-Fi? I asked, I was stupid. It's my mistake. I asked them, do you have Wi-Fi? Yeah, we have. Like, we have a router there in the corner. It just doesn't work, you know?
That's a really good cultural explanation. I like that.
Yeah, that's just the mentality. The next mentality I have is there is a fish market. I go with my girlfriend. She's Chinese. We go to the fish market and she goes alone. And she gets whatever she buys, cabbage, even though it's a fish market, they sell cabbage as well. Anyway, so she buys a piece of cabbage, let's say $1, right? I go with her, the cabbage is $2. So we ask the sellers, like, why is the price up now? Oh, because you're a foreigner, you're rich, right? So that's the, he was very honest, right? Which is, I appreciate that, you know? But this is kind of the mentality. So, this is one of the things that if you go on Alibaba and if you try this directly and people know that you don't have experience, you're not going to get the best prices. Also, you cannot distinguish, is this a manufacturer or is this a trading company? The trading companies buy from the manufacturers and then they resell the products. Obviously, they need to have a margin on that and that's how they make the money. But to be honest, if you work directly with a manufacturer, they don't, like, if you order 1,000 units, they don't care if it's a dollar more or a dollar less for the product. They don't care. It's not like at that amount, this is the price. You know, you buy some units, you go with them, you grow with them. You have, you know, later on, once you're good, once you're selling, then you can go and negotiate. Then you can get better prices. Then you can get better payment terms. Then you can get better, you know, terms in general. You might be able to get a credit in that. You might be able to pay them 60 days after you ordered. You know, so I think a lot of people focus directly on the price. Oh, I need to find a supplier right now with the best price, right? But this is not necessarily like the supplier.
Pretty short term.
We work with manufacturers. They do $3 billion a year. If you order 1,000 units, whether you pay $5,000 or $4,800, it doesn't make a difference.